pensando com a lens. The best and worst candidates for becoming a redhead. Best candidates, those with a natural level 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. The worst candidates are levels 1, 2, 8, 9, and 10. Does that make sense? This is what it's like on the chart, folks. You can still write the same thing down. I have it. This is 3, 4, this is the best. The red region are your best candidates. Red region, right here, I call it the red region, okay? From level 3 to level 7, that's your red region. Anybody, any kind of customer you have in that category wants to be a redhead, great. Why is it great? Who can tell me? That's right, she's got a ring right in her hair. So now my product doesn't have to do so much. Right, the product has to lift it, contribute some, but I'm getting a lot of contributing natural pigment from her hair already. So the combination is a marriage made in heaven. You know what I'm saying? It's like, wow, I'm gonna get a really good full body redhead. What's what I mean by full body is it's gonna look nice and full and rich. It's not gonna be a puny, you know, mousy redhead, right? And it's gonna be long lasting, less fadeage, because the natural contributing pigment is gonna contribute a lot. Now your worst candidates, of course, are levels 1 or 2. Levels 1 or 2 are too dark to create a bright, vibrant redhead unless you pre-light them first. Alright? Now in the book, I talk about two ways to do dark people, dark hair color people, excuse me, dark level 1, 2 people, make them a redhead. One is what we call double process redheads, which I explained real thoroughly how to do that, and the other is what we call high lift redheads. And that's a technique whereby you use your target shade, like we talked about earlier, maybe a 5RV, and mix it with something very light, like let's say like a 12G. Okay, and with like 30 volume. So the idea behind that is you're getting the extra ammonia content from the very light color that's gonna help pump up the lighting process, and of course your red is gonna contribute to the color that you need, all right? And again, if you've never done this before, you wanna maybe do a test strand first, you can really see what you're gonna get first. And the other way to do it here is what I call double process redheads, and that's where you go in there first with their lightener. By the way, as far as lighteners go, my personal opinion, and I talk a lot about this in the book, is I like oil-based lighteners. What do I mean by oil-based lighteners? I mean like powdered bleaches and stuff like that. I've gotten away from it. I mean, I really use a lot of, you know, I don't like to promote products, but I will say about one that I made, that we all use tons, and that's Warm Blonde. Old-fashioned flare-up Warm Blonde. I mean, there's a lot out there, you don't have to use that one. But my point is that I find that the oil lighteners leave the hair in really better condition. Keep this in mind about lightening hair and bleaches. Is the slower you do it, the better the condition the hair stays in, right? The faster you do it, the more you can dry out that hair, okay? So if a client comes in, she wants to be, and you use a darker level, and I have a friend of mine, just right here, called Robert Reyes, he lives in San Antonio, Texas. Anyway, he has a lot of like Latin American girls, like they're like Spanish, Mexican girls, and he makes them light on redheads. And how he does it is exactly what I'm gonna tell you right now, okay? He first takes them to the sink, and he is like, kind of wipes their hair down, he mixes a lightener up, puts the lightener all over, right at the sink, just like roots to ends, and breaks the base. Everybody knows how to break the base? Okay? But he doesn't just break the base, he actually brings up like an orange, like an ugly orange, all right? Right? Then he washes that off, and then he puts the color on that he wants, the real color he wants, the red hair that he wants, and they look incredible. And these girls, they come to him for years, because he's the only one in town that knows how to make that dark hair vibrant. And it's a wonderful way to do it. Now, of course, it's a high ticket item because you're doing two things. But remember, you don't have to leave the bleach on until the hair becomes white. That's not what we're talking about. You just leave it on just long enough until you start seeing that blue wash off and you start seeing that orange come through. Now you know you got a really good base for your red, right? And of course, you come back for a touch up, you now have to do the same thing. But it's pretty quick at that point because you don't have a cold shaft to deal with. You only put the lightener on the regrowth area only. As soon as you see it start to come up, you take it right off, then put your color on your regrowth area. Because what is the double process? But it's not like a double process blonde where it can take, you know, 45 minutes or an hour to come up. It's a pretty quick process. Unless she has really long hair, you got a long cold shaft, maybe I will put it on there first, start lighting that up, and then get it up in a root area.
Is there an oil bleach that you're talking about?
Sorry?
Is there an oil bleach?
Yeah, I would use oil bleach for that. Yeah, I would use oil bleach. They go, the oil bleaches you can use, they call activators or propanators. The one that I like to use is by Claro. It's called Warm Blonde.
Warm Blonde.
Warm Blonde. But again, there's every manufacturer has them, so I'm not trying to promote any product here. That's just one I prefer to use. And I've been using it for years, and I actually use it for everything. I use it on the scalp bleach, off the scalp bleach. I use it for color correction. I use it to take out a puff. I use it for everything. But I talk a lot about it in the book because I, to me, powder lighteners are too aggressive for the kind of work that I like to do nowadays. You know what I mean? And I know the name of the game is to keep a client happy and keep her hair looking great over a long period of time, you gotta keep your hair in good condition. Because once the hair is over heavily abused, it's too dried out because of heavy duty bleaches or whatever it is, you'll never get a good color to stay. And you'll beat your head against the wall trying to make that hair, the color look right. It's never gonna look right, okay? The name of the game is keep the hair in great condition and you're gonna have great looking color.
David?
Yes?
Question.
Yes?
No, David, I have a question. I don't know if this has happened to everybody around the country, but it seems like so many heads are coming in way over processed now. Not just with, I'm talking about a length and scalp one, but it seems like they're so over 40. We seem to just do nothing but corrections.
Right. What you know, like I said a few minutes ago, Frank, I don't know if you were here or not. You know, every head here is just my chair, I consider it to be a color correction. You know? But he's right, you know. You know why? Because it's the easy way to do it. Okay? This is why we get those people all the time. Because most hairdressers, you know, I don't even want to call them colorists, they're hairdressers, they're doing color, they don't know the stuff I'm telling you now, folks. You know, all they know is go back there, get the basic white, and throw it on. You know, bleach that hair up. And, you know, eventually the girls come into your salon, their hair's all breaking off all over the place. And they wonder why. Well, because of what's happening. So use the most gentle product possible to make it work. All right, now your lighter colors here, let's talk about that for a second. Levels 8, 9, and 10 are too light just to say a good, rich redhead, but they're okay for your red blondes, copper blondes, and apricots. Okay? In other words, if you want something very, very light, very, very delicate, you can do that. If you want really good, dark, rich, full body red, I'd kind of stay away from that. Because let me tell you why. If you do it, it's like, I mean, you can do it, but when you have it, what happens is she'll leave the salon, her hair will be nice and rich and full body, what I call full body, all right? And a couple weeks later, her hair looks mauvey or pinky, because there's not enough warmth in her hair, all right? It fades away very quickly, and the reason is because you're 100% dependent on the dye load of the color for your end result. You're not dependent on the dye load and the contributing pigment. Remember I said that before? You have to have a dye load, and you got to have your contributing pigment. Together, they make color work, okay? If you only have one, and it's all artificial dye, and then you're not getting nothing from the lady's hair or the man's hair, all right, it's not going to work. It'll work temporarily, but in a couple weeks, 8, 10, 12 days down the road, if she shampoos her hair every day, she's gonna be a very weak, faint redhead. It's not gonna look nice, all right? But if she wants to be a red blonde, that's a different story. You know, like a light copper, or like an apricot, you know, talking about those shades, you know, that works fine, all right?